Maybe.
Milan, 5 a.m. This is going to be a very long travel day.
Here we are
in San Salvador.
We wanted to shoot our first vlog outdoor today, but it's pouring, so you have to settle for our hotel room.
Yes, we are at the Cinco Hotel, our favorite hotel in San Salvador that we booked in Milan because we know that it's Bitcoin friendly.
We have to admit that our first week here was more difficult than what we expected. Our impression is that Bitcoin adoption in the country has not improved at all. Quite the contrary.
1 year ago, the hardest part for us was finding hotels that accepted Bitcoin. But this time, even the easiest thing, like buying a SIM card or finding food, took quite a little bit of effort.
Yep.
We have to admit that Bitcoins today depends on the internet. So if someone wants to do what we're doing, traveling in Bitcoin only,
the first thing to do is find a local SIM card. Also because roaming here, super expensive. The connection in El Salvador, on the other hand, is excellent. We have 5G connection everywhere in the country, even up in the mountains.
In the jungle. We were also a little bit unlucky.
Yes, we ran into something they call El Día de los Muertos. It's a Central American version of Halloween. It's bank holiday and all the shops were closed.
The next day, however, everything was open, so the hunt finally begins.
Buenas.
Buenas.
Buenas tardes, señora. ¿Te gustaría comprar tres chip para el móvil?
¿De qué operador?
No lo sé. Una pregunta, por favor. Yo necesito que pagar con Bitcoin.
¿Con Bitcoin?
Porque yo tengo solo Bitcoin.
No, no lo tiene disponible ahorita.
Gracias, señora. Questo è interessante. Buenas tardes, señora. Yo necesito de tres SIM para mi móvil. La única cosa, yo aceptan Bitcoin también?
No, solo efectivo.
Solo efectivo. Sí. ¿Por qué tipo no aceptan Bitcoin?
Fíjense que no sabría decirle porque ya eso es interno de ellos. Sí, solo aceptamos efectivo para la compra de chip.
Vale. Lo siento mucho, yo tengo solo Bitcoin.
Okay.
Tigo es una compañía nacional aquí, claro.
Ok, interesante.
Gracias.
¿Puedes pagar también con Bitcoin?
No.
¿No Bitcoin aquí? Ok, ok. ¿No tienen el Chivo Wallet?
No.
Ok, nosotros tenemos solo Bitcoin, somos periodistas italianos de Bitcoin. Me siento mucho.
Buenas tardes, señora. Yo necesito comprar 3 SIM para el móvil.
¿Para mi celular?
Sí, no una recarga, el chip. ¿Lo tiene?
Claro,
se le ha preparado. Un'altra pregunta, señorita. Yo necesito que pagar en Bitcoin. ¿Es posible?
No
se puede pagar en Bitcoin.
No tenemos ahorita habilitado.
¿Ahora o no la
no
es?
Tenemos habilitado.
No tienes Chivo Wallet, el wallet de Chivo. Vale, gracias.
Bueno.
I have the feeling something has changed in El Salvador, my friends. Claro, one of the biggest company in El Salvador. Hola, buenas tardes. Yo necesito comprar 3 SIM card para el móvil. Pero necesito que pagar con Bitcoin.
No se puede.
Claro, the most important company here in El Salvador. Let's try Digicel. Signora, io necessito comprare 3 SIM per il mobile. Tengo que pagar con Bitcoin. Gracias.
Okay.
We made it.
Even the restaurant we expected to be more Bitcoin friendly than the last year.
Yes, running around the city, we bumped into a lot of restaurants with the Bitcoin logo or the Strike logo quite visible outside on their windows. But when you actually walk in and ask them if you can pay in Bitcoin, their answer is no. They don't accept Bitcoin anymore. Because it's too complex, they say, and they had too few transactions.
When we finally find one, we sit down to eat our sandwiches, but then when is the moment to pay, the cashier
panic. He started looking for a dusty tablet down in a drawer. He apologized. The battery of the tablet is completely drained. So first of all, he has to recharge the tablet. And then
a few phone calls started. No one could remember the PIN of the tablet. But then when they showed us the QR code,
when they finally made it, the lightning transaction was
super fast.
Lightning fast.
El Salvador is a small country. The main roads here are safe. And it's easy to drive around. The best way to travel it is renting a car. But is it possible to do it in Bitcoin? Let's find out!
Buenas tardes, señora. Me gustaría alquilar un coche. Ma yo quiero que pagarlo en Bitcoin. ¿Es posible, por favor?
Sí,
No, no tenemos servicio de Bitcoin en estos momentos.
Permítame un segundito.
Claro.
No lo tenemos habilitado ahorita acá.
Okay, un gusto. En este momento únicamente el pago sería en efectivo o con tarjeta.
Okay. Solo efectivo y solo tarjeta. Enterprise no acepta el Bitcoin.
Por el momento acá en El Salvador, solamente en efectivo.
Solo efectivo, solo con tarjeta, perdón. No tenemos la opción para el Bitcoin, fíjense.
Don Ricardo, le comento, la forma de pago puede ser en efectivo o a través de su tarjeta.
No Bitcoin.
Únicamente tarjeta o en efectivo.
Renting a car and paying for it in Bitcoin here in El Salvador, it's possible, but not easy. None of the big international companies accept it. Budget, Avis, Hertz, Enterprise, Alamo, forget about them. What you better do is to use Google Maps to find all the rental cars available in the city and start calling all the small businesses, the family-owned one. And indeed, buenas tardes, señor. Una pregunta. Yo necesito alquilar un coche en San Salvador, pero me gustaría pagarlo con el Bitcoin, si es posible.
Ok, vaya, sí se podría, no hay ningún problema.
We noticed this trend everywhere in the country, even on our previous trip here. It's as if the largest and more established companies are snobbing Bitcoin. It's the medium-small merchants who often see it as an opportunity to attract new customers. Better for them. We are a little worried at this point about the outcome of our trip. In this first week in San Salvador, we went to all our favorite bars, restaurants. We know those places because 1 year ago they were accepting Bitcoin, so we were used to hang out there. But this time, 75% of them, they no longer do.
This is something we should have noticed since the beginning. Last year, the city was full of signs and advertising Bitcoin or Bitcoin related.
This time, no more. You don't have that feeling of welcome to the Bitcoin country you had back then,
From the airport,
basically. Next week, we will be leaving again the big city and we will go outside in the most remote areas of the country.
And I'm a little bit scared of that.
It's gonna be fine, I guess. For anyone of you guys that wants to follow our journey more closely, please subscribe to our social media and read our daily diary. Every day we drop a new article. Down here, right in the comments of this video, you will find all the links you need to do so. So, we left our hotel for a round of drinks here in San Salvador.
We went to our favorite spot from the last year where we got drunk.
Yes, every night.
Because they accepted Bitcoin, but
they don't accept Bitcoin anymore.
They don't accept Bitcoin anymore.
So no drinks and no beers for Ricky and Laura.
Whoa.
We look for something else. Gracias.
Es una pregunta, por favor. ¿Aceptan Bitcoin aquí? Nosotros tenemos que pagar con Bitcoin.
¿Sí?
¿Sí?
Bitcoin. Sí, ¿verdad?
Okay. Perfecto. Sí. Muchas gracias.
Gracias.
Bien. Bien.